out your headlights.
There's a blackout, sir. I guess you didn't hear the siren.
Well, the streetlights are still on.
They'll be off in a minute. They have to be very careful about throwing the main switch. There, you see?
Look, Howard doesn't trust me out alone, even when the lights are...
I'm sorry, but you'll have to wait for the all-clear signal.
Well, you're the boss. Piece of candy?
Oh, I can't. I'm on duty. Thanks, anyway.
Yep. Hi, boys. Now, let me catch anybody's hands in my pockets except my own.
Who's that guy hot putting this way?
Looks like Wilkins, the bookkeeper.
Now, see here, fellas. You know you're supposed to put out your lights.
Sure. Have them out in a jiffy, Mr. Wilkins.
I'd appreciate it, Jordan. You're working kind of late, aren't you?
So are you, pal. Only you ain't getting paid for it.
I'm glad I can be useful.
There, how's that suit you?
Oh, that's fine. Oh, how about these here?
Well, Stokes is inside. Ask him about it.
Oh, all right. Oh, Mr. Stokes.
Yes, Wilkins. Something I can do for you?
Your lights, they might be seen from the dock side.
All right, I'll attend to it right away.
I didn't know you were working tonight. It's way past closing time.
You've been keeping books for this company for a long time, haven't you, Wilkins?
Oh, yes, a good many years now.
Then you ought to know that old man Bates works his men till they drop.
I see what you mean. Well, what's that raw silk doing out of stock? I thought that was all frozen by government order.
Suppose you take care of your bookkeeping, and I'll handle the shipping department.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Good night, Wilkins.
Good night, sir.
Jordan.
Yeah?
Get that stuff moving right away.
That's against the rules, sir.
What is?
Lighting a match. It could be seen by enemy flyers at 5,000 feet.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, look! They'd see that from 25,000 feet.
A bomb would serve those fellas right.
Watch it. Somebody's flagging us down.
Lights out! Blackout!
Pinheaded Chuck Wilkins again.
Pull over! Stop! Stop!
That was a pretty close call, mister.
Yeah.
By the way, could I interest you in an accident insurance policy?
Nope. Did you get their license numbers?
Nope.
Oh.
Emily, my Emily.
Good morning.
Did you see that?
Not yet.
Oh, I just picked it up for you.
That's very kind and considerate of you, Mr. Wilkins.
You're welcome.
Good morning, Mike.
Good morning, Mr. Wilkins.
He loses 3 minutes every day.
Goodbye, Mike. Goodbye, Mr. Wilkins.
I'm sorry, sir. That seat is taken. Would you mind sitting over here?
Not at all.
It's a funny thing. You know, less than a half a minute, a fellow would walk in here by the name of Mr. Wilkins. He ain't been late in 15 years. Yes, sir. Ever since I opened up this joint, I know exactly what he's going to say. Good morning. How's your morale this morning?
Good morning. How's your morale this morning?
Sky high, boy. Sky high. You know, did you do...
Good morning, Mary.
Good morning, sir.
How's the morale this morning?
Shorter in sequence of the occasion, sir.
I'll take the usual. There you are.
Thank you, sir.
See you tomorrow, Mary.
Bye, Mr. Wilkins.
Hey, it's people like you that... Hello, Perry.
Hi, Wilkins. How's tinfoil collection coming along?
Oh, not bad. Not bad at all.
You ought to have enough by now to build a bomber.
Uh-huh. How are things down at the bank?
All swell. I'm in charge of the loan department now.
That's quite a jump from your old job with Bates and Company.
Biggest favor Bates ever did was firing me. Hey, tell me about yourself. You married?
No.
What? I thought you and Emily got married years ago.
I can't afford to get married.
Hey, look, it's none of my business, but how much is Bates paying you now?
40 a week.
That's what you were getting 3 years ago. Uh-huh. What you need is intestinal fortitude.
You think so?
Sure, you've got to fight, man. Get in there and bat for yourself if you expect to get anyplace.
But how?
How? Listen, Hubert, this is no world for timid men. Open that door. Walk right up to Bates like you meant it and say, I want a raise.
What do you think this is, a parking lot? Get going.
Yes.
See you. Bye.
Again.
That's right. Now you want to try for a $4 question? Why am I late?
This is no joking matter.
I'll say it ain't. I punctured a tire on my bike.
I don't believe it. You had the same excuse yesterday morning.
Sure, I haven't been able to get a new tire yet. The priorities committee will be acting on my case any day now.
I'll be acting on your case any minute if you don't get busy.
Hi, Toots.
Good morning, Emily.
Good morning, Hubert.
Jimmy, Billy Wells. You look lovely, Emily, as usual.
Thank you, Hubert. You always do start my day out right.
So do you. I mean, for me.
There. That's better.
Thank you.
Squirt of vitamin B19.
Yeah. Mr. Bates here yet?
Not yet.
Gosh, I thought it was late.
You look like you'd been up all night.
Oh, I have. Waiting for a baby to be born is no fun.
Oh, I know. When Aunt Clarissa had hers,
Well, she's standing a lot better than I am.
Oh, don't be nervous. Everything will be fine.
Oh, sure it will.
Well, the nurse is going to telephone me from the hospital. Gosh, I'm shaking like a leaf.
Oh, take it easy, Clark. There's nothing to be worried about.
Well, that's for me.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello?
Gee, they don't answer.
Bates and Company? Huh? Yeah, he's here.
Oh, excuse me. Give me that phone.
You better let him talk.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? What's that? You'll have to talk louder. Birth? She did?
It's a girl.
Yeah? He is?
No, it's a boy.
Boy.
Yeah? I didn't get that. Oh, yes, 8.
8 pounds? Bouncing?
Yes. Sure, you bet. I'll tell him. That was a pier office calling. The freighter Balboa just docked at berth 8. They're starting to unload.
Oh. Oh, well. Well, there's no telling how long you'll have to wait. Let's all try to get down to business.
Hello? You bet. Hold on. It's for you, Mr. Clark.
Yeah, here it is.
Here's Mrs. Clark.
Swell.
Oh. How's my wife? Oh, great. Yeah, I'll be over right away.
Oh, yeah.
Boy or girl?
Girl, boy, of course.
Many happy returns. I mean, congratulations. Look, you take the whole day off. I'll do your work for you.
Much obliged.
Yeah. Oh, your hat. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yes? He's just leaving. What's that? No kidding. It's another one. A girl.
Twins?
Yep. A doubleheader.
Gosh. Twice a father.
I never saw a man so happy. It's not going to be easy managing on his salary, though.
I imagine his wife will do the managing. Women are like that, you know.
Yes, but Clark's always worried about money. Always in debt.
And still he's happy. Don't forget that.
I'll get this one. Yeah, he's going... It's for you. I'm sorry.
Good morning. Bates and Company. No, Mr. Bates hasn't come in yet, but I expect him in a few minutes. Will you call later, Mr. Randall? Thank you.
Was that Perry Randall?
Yes, why?
I had quite a talk with him this morning. He said I ought to hit Mr. Bates for a raise.
Well, why don't you? What can you lose?
Nothing, except my job.
Oh, I doubt it. What else did Perry say?
He was surprised that we... that I wasn't married yet.
Oh, well, don't let him rush you. Some people don't get married until they're 70.
Oh, I don't intend to wait that long.
No?
No. Oh. If I could only get Mr. Bates to give me a raise.
Now, listen, Hubert. When a woman loves a man, she doesn't care how much money he makes.
Really?
Really. So if that's all that's stopping you...
Nothing is going to stop me.
That's the way I like to hear you talk.
Colored ink from red to green to blue, Wilkins, I'll be right with you. Erasers, clips and papers, carbons, pastes and glue. Well, speak up. If Fuller hasn't got it, it ain't. Hiya, Emily.
My, but you look sweet today.
When are they going to start the ration you?
Good morning, Mr. Fuller.
Oh, look at those lovely blue eyes and that wonderful brown wavy hair. It's got me. And that lovely, lovely hand.
Ruined by a broken nail. What you need is a set of our rubber typewriter keys, and I only have a few left.
Not today, thank you.
How about a typewriter ribbon, some carbons, ink blotters, pencils? You must need something.
I said not today.
Very well, Your Highness. Never let it be said that high-pressure Fuller couldn't take no for an answer. I bow to your wishes. I go, but I shall return. Goodbye, everybody. See you next week.
Mr. Fuller. Well, just, haven't you forgotten something?
Have I?
Could I see you a minute?
Sure.
About that loan.
Oh, of course. I almost forgot. That's really why I dropped in here this morning.
When you borrowed that $400, you said you'd pay me back in 60 days. Well, it's been 6 months.
Wilkins, I'm surprised at you. You're holding the deeds to 4 very valuable pieces of property. They're worth at least twice what I owe you. And besides, you're charging me 7% interest.
Well, you haven't paid that either.
But you've got it coming.
Look, I want to buy some more war savings bonds, and that money would come in very handy.
Okay. If you want your money, you can have it. I'll... sell my lots and pay you off.
Oh, no, don't do that. I wouldn't want you to take a loss.
I'd sooner lose my lots than lose your friendship.
Oh, no, I wouldn't hear of it, no.
I tell you what, Wilkins,
Remember that wealthy aunt I spoke to you about?
Oh, yes, in Poughkeepsie.
That's the one. Well, I got a letter yesterday saying they don't expect her to last much longer. When it happens, I'll settle up with you. How's that for good news?
Oh, that's fine. That's
okay, Wilkins.
Oh, no. Well, funny boy.
Hubert.
Hmm?
I couldn't help overhearing what Fuller said to you.
Oh, he means all right, Emily.
But he never pays his debts.
Oh, now, you're just suspicious. You heard him say he'd pay me soon.
Oh, surely you don't believe that silly story about his wealthy aunt.
Huh?
Hubert, you're entirely too easy. You shouldn't let people take advantage of you.
Do you think they do, Emily? Oh, good morning.
Good morning, Mr.
Good morning.
Three copies.
Any calls for me?
Only Mr. Randall at the bank.
We'll get him on the phone.
Yes, sir.
Where's Clark?
At the hospital. His wife.
Another baby?
Two.
Mr. Randall? One moment, please. I'll connect you with Mr. Bates. Mr. Bates, I have Mr. Randall for you.
Emily, remember, this is no world for timid men.
What?
That's what I said. Mustn't be timid. You know what you want. Tell him. I've made up my mind and nothing is going to stop me.
The guy's fast. He's talking to himself.
Jimmy.
You surprise me. You know how business conditions are at present. As a banker, you must realize that $25,000 is a lot of money to dig up on short notice. Can't you arrange another extension?
I'm sorry, Bates, but yours is a call loan. We'd like to have you take care of it immediately.
That's impossible. Now look, Perry, you know my business depends on imports and exports, and silk is my principal commodity. Now with the war and the government order to freeze all silk, my hands are tied. You've just got to give me more time.
I realize that, but...
After all, you're fully secured. The silk I put up more than covers the loan.
Well, all right. How about another 2 weeks?
Well, thanks. I appreciate it. Impudent pup. Glad I fired him. Well, what is it, Wilkins?
Nothing. Nothing important, Mr. Bates.
Come, out with it. Out with it.
Mr. Bates, I have been working for you for more than 15 years.
Well, what do you want, a pension?
No, sir. A raise.
Did I understand you to say a raise?
Yes, sir. I feel that my loyalty...
You can show your loyalty by getting back to work.
You mean you won't...
I mean, if you're not satisfied, you can quit.
Oh, I wouldn't think of leaving.
Well, then, don't pester me. I've got worries of my own.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Quickly.
Put me on the beam. Where is she?
Oh, she didn't know when to expect me. She asked me to give you this.
Oh. Well. Contact. Boy, that's what I call super osculation.
Shh. What brought that on?
Sally's orders, you see. Give Emily the first kiss, bring the rest with you.
Oh.
Say, I gotta be going. Is Dad in?
Yes.
How's he feeling? In a good humor?
Ask him. He just saw him.
Well, Hubert, what about him?
Maybe I better wait till his blood pressure goes down.
After what I gotta tell him, it's gonna jump right back up again. So why wait? Hiya, Dad. Remember me?
Hubert.
Yes, Emily?
Don't take it so badly. It isn't worth it.
What do you mean?
You can't keep anything from me. Mr. Bates turned you down, didn't he?
Uh-huh.
Will you do me a great big favor?
Oh, why, anything.
Just smile. That's all. Oh, more. That's fine.
Son, I've listened to everything you've had to say, and I still think you're making a mistake.
Well, since when is marrying the girl you're in love with a mistake?
When it stands in the way of your future.
My future?
Don't you understand? This is no time to tie yourself down. You're in the service. For how long, nobody knows. And when this thing's over and you come back and establish yourself in business, that's the time to think about marriage.
I don't see it that way at all. I'm thinking about the present. It's the only thing I'm sure of.
Then is it fair to the girl to marry you and have you go away?
Well, thousands of girls are married to men in the service. They must...
If she has your best interest at heart, she'll be willing to wait.
Well, what if she doesn't wait? What if I should lose, Sally?
Then you'll be better off.
How can you say that?
Son, I've tried to reason with you and convince you that marriage at this time should be out of the question. But if you insist, then I want you to know I don't approve of your choice.
You don't approve?
No, sir.
Look, Dad, did your father choose Mother?
Certainly not.
Well, who did?
I did, of course.
There, you see? We young fellows know best. You know, Dad, you're about old enough now for us to have a man-to-man talk. I feel you should know certain facts.
Here, Jimmy, more fan mail for you.
You're getting more popular every day.
It's my personality, Mr. Jepson.
And here's something extra special. Be very careful with it.
Zowie! Message from headquarters, sir.
What's wrong with you, Timmy?
Nothing except that I'm too young to get one of those.
Selective service, official business.
Wait a minute, Admiral. There's big goings on here.
Why, what's up?
Mr. Wilkins just received a message from the president.
No kidding.
Hubert, is it really?
Mm-hmm. Selectee Hubert Theodore Wilkins. It's from my draft board, ordering me to report for my physical examination.
You're in the Army now. You're not behind the plow.
But that... Oh, that's wonderful. You'll be handsome in a uniform.
Will I? Maybe you're right.
Congratulations. I wish you were going to be in my outfit.
Oh, so do I, Don. But I'll take what they give me and like it.
They give you everything. Now you can throw away your budget.
I hadn't thought of that.
The recruiting station is right on my way. If you go now, I can give you a lift.
Oh, I can't leave my work. What would Mr. Bates say?
Leave it to me. I'll square you.
There's nothing to square. You've got a new job in the Army.
That's right, Don. That's right. Well, what are we waiting for? Come on. Let's go.
Come on, soldier.
Yes, sir. Sir. Wish me luck, Emily.
I do, Hubert. We all do.
So long, everybody.
Say, Don, about this physical examination, is it hard to pass?
No, it's a cinch. The first one, anyway.
Well, give me an idea.
Well, can you see lightning?
Certainly.
Can you hear thunder?
Of course.
Can you eat a big, thick, juicy beefsteak?
Oh, you bet.
Well, you've got nothing to worry about. You'll pass.
Oh. Are you kidding me? Oh. Oh, I see.
Right over there, please. Next. Hubert Theodore Wilkins.
Yes, sir. Will this take long?
It'll be over like that.
Like that?
Well, much quicker. Yeah. Over here, please.
Yes, sir.
Right over there, please. Are you men stripped to the waist, please? Come on, shake it up a little faster. Step lively, move along. Next, step lively, move along. Next, to it. Hop to it, 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 hop to it. Next.
Well, fella, was that quick enough for you?
I'll say it was. How did I make out?
Well, the major has your papers, he'll tell you.
Oh. Pardon me. Could you tell me how I stand? My name is Wilkins. Hubert Theodore Wilkins.
Uh-huh. Wilkins. You're all set. Report at 8 o'clock Friday morning. You'll get your final exam at the induction center.
Oh, I made it. I'm in. Thanks. You don't know what this means to me.
I repeat, nothing is too good for our men in the service. And nothing should be too difficult for those of us who must remain on the home front. Taking an example from men like Hubert Wilkins, we should consider no sacrifice too great in the cause of freedom. In this way, we shall win a lasting victory and bring an end to war. Mr. Wilkins, I should say Hubert, these little remembrances are from your friends and co-workers, expressions of the high regard in which they hold you. And here is a token of my own esteem. Well, to show my appreciation for your years of faithful service.
Thank you.
And now will you say a few words, Hubert?
Dinner and the presents and everything. I guess there aren't many fellas that get a send-off like this, and I'm not so sure that I deserve it. Mr. Bates said so many nice things. I'm not sure I can live up to them.
Because after all, I'm just an average man who's held down an average job, and I'll probably turn out just to be an average soldier. We can't all be great heroes. There are millions of us fellas whose job it is to follow our leaders and do the best we can. In a way, going to war is like working for this company. I mean, Mr. Bates has been like my commander-in-chief, and I've been one of his men, doing what I'm told, just like all of you. Now I have a new commander-in-chief, and I guess I'll just keep on doing what I'm told. Well, anyway, thanks, everybody. I guess that's about all. Except it's been swell knowing you.
Mr. Wilkins' words were modest and sincere. And I have great pleasure in saying that the doors of Bates and Company will always be open to him. Your job will be waiting for you when you get back.
Thanks, Mr. Bates.
Now I know you're all anxious to get home so you can get a good night's rest and be ready for a hard day's work tomorrow.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Why?
You seemed so happy earlier this evening, and now you look sort of glum. You've hardly said a word in blocks.
I'm sorry, Emily. I didn't mean to be such dull company. It's just that...
Go on. Tell me.
Well, I've been thinking. This is probably the last evening we'll spend together for a long time.
I know. I'll miss you.
Will you? Honest?
Terribly.
I don't see how I'm going to stand it. Not seeing you and not talking to you. Going to the places that we like.
Well, maybe you'll be stationed at a camp nearby.
But what if I'm not?
We can write often, and you'll get leave once in a while.
When I think of all the time I've wasted, I could kick myself. We could have been married years ago if...
Yes.
If I hadn't been such a coward about asking you. Of course, I don't know if you would have been willing.
Well, there's only one way of finding that out.
I didn't think I was making enough money to get married. I was waiting for a raise. Now it's too late.
I wonder.
Well, if I couldn't see my way clear on a salary of $40 a week, what chance would I have on a soldier's pay?
Lots of girls keep on working.
Oh, I wouldn't want my wife to work. I've got to do it right, the way I see it, or not at all.
Do you know what?
What?
You're enough to drive a girl crazy.
Why, Emily, you're angry. What have I done?
It's what you haven't done. Did you ever think of kissing a girl?
Oh, yes. Oh, you mean you want me? You'd actually let me kiss you?
Well, it might get you further than waiting around for a raise and... And more fun, too.
Gee, I never thought of... Gee. Imagine a girl being mad because a man didn't have nerve enough to kiss her. Oh, Emily, my Emily, da-dee-dee-dee.
Jimmy. Jimmy. Come here. Give these statements to Miss Conway.
Okay, Chief, you careful?
Yes?
Please come in.
Yes, Mr. Bates. Hey, to us, Clark.
Oh, later, later.
She was too busy to see me, but I'll bet a big shot like you could get an appointment.
You're always giving me an argument of some kind.
Well, look who's here. Hiya, Mr. Wilkins.
Are we glad to see you.
Is the war over already?
I just dropped in to say hello and return these presents.
How come?
Well, it's nothing to be very proud of, but the Army changed its mind.
You're kidding.
I wish it were. Funny thing. I passed everything okay. Then at the induction headquarters, it got kind of windy and I started sneezing. Couldn't stop.
And they turned you down for that?
Said I was allergic to dust.
That's the first time I ever heard of a guy sneezing himself out of the Army.
Oh, very unusual. Nothing I could do about it. Well, here,
Here's the safety razor you gave me, Jimmy.
If you let me borrow your whiskers, I might have some use for it. Gee, I'm sorry, Mr. Wilkins.
Forget it. It's a nice pen, Clark, but I won't be writing very many letters. Thanks just the same.
Well, I don't want it back, but there's no use arguing with you about it.
No. Where's Emily?
She's in with his nibs.
Oh.
And in closing, wish to repeat, I have great confidence in the development of our South American market. Yours very truly. Got it?
Yes, sir. Is that all, Mr. Bates?
No, there's something else. I've been wanting to have a little chat with you for the last few days.
About my work?
No, it's rather a personal matter, and it's very important to me.
Yes?
It's about Don. In fact, you know, Miss Conway, children sometimes think their parents don't understand them, while it's they who don't understand their parents.
Perhaps you're right.
I know I'm right. Now, take Don, for instance. He's been home for a week, and I've scarcely seen him. He's out when I get home and asleep when I leave in the morning.
If you think that's Sally's fault...
I'm not saying whose fault it is, but I do object to the hours he's keeping. Perhaps they shouldn't see each other so late and so often.
But surely you don't expect me to interfere, Mr. Bates.
I simply want you to understand my feelings in this matter. Frankly, I'm very much opposed to Don's silly notion that he wants to get married.
I don't see anything silly about it. They're in love.
It doesn't fit in with the plans I've made for his future. I've told Don that this is no time for him to think of marriage.
Oh, but I'm sure Sally would be willing to wait.
To be quite blunt, I'd rather she didn't.
You'd rather she didn't?
No reflections, you understand. It's my boy's happiness I'm concerned about.
I'm just as concerned about Sally's happiness, and I'm sure neither of them will find it without the other. Is that all, Mr. Bates?
No, it's not. I sent for you hoping you'd see my point of view and use your influence to break off this affair.
Affair, did you say?
Well, call it anything you like. I expect you to put an end to it.
And I prefer to mind my own business.
Miss Conway, you've been working for this firm for several years, and your services up to date have been very satisfactory.
Meaning?
I hope matters work out so that you'll continue in our employ.
I understand, Mr. Bates. I'll speak to my sister tonight.
Good.
Emily.
Darling!
Uh-oh. I guess you didn't expect to see me so soon, did you?
Oh, no, but I'm glad.
Miss Conway, you forgot... Well, if it isn't Wilkins.
Hello, Mr. Bates.
Glad you dropped by. Haven't forgotten your old friends, I see.
I was waiting to see you. Could you spare me a minute?
Why, of course. Come right in. Come right in.
Thank you.
Sit down. Tell me about yourself.
Thank you.
Why aren't you in uniform?
Well, you see, Mr. Bates, that's what I've come to talk to you about. The Army can't use me. A kind of a physical disability. I won't bother you with details.
That's too bad. I thought you were all set.
So did I, but it just didn't work out that way. So I've come to ask you if I can have my old job back.
This puts me in an awkward spot, Wilkins. I hardly know what to say.
At the farewell dinner, you...
Yes, I know. I promised your job would be waiting for you, but I hadn't counted on your turning up so soon.
I realize that. Well...
No, don't go yet. This will be a hard blow for Clark. However...
Oh, no, I wouldn't feel right about that. Clark has a family, and this promotion means a lot to him. I'll get along somehow.
I hadn't intended to fill Clark's old position, but if you want it, you can have it.
Oh, that'll be fine.
The salary will be $25 a week.
$25 a week? You've been paying Clark $30.
That has nothing to do with it. You can take it or leave it.
I haven't much choice in the matter. I guess I'll have to take
it. You can go to work right now.
I want to return this check you gave me for a going-away present.
Oh, I don't want it. You can just tear it up.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes.
Jimmy told me. Oh, I know how disappointed you are, Hubert, but don't feel too badly. After all, you were more than willing to go.
As long as you understand, Emily, it helps a lot. Anyway, I've got a job.
Oh, where?
Here.
At more money?
Army, they call this kitchen police and hate it. In the home, men call it helping the little woman and love it, the liars.
Hubert, I'm glad you're setting such a good example in the kitchen for Don. He may get married someday.
Well, there's no may about it. I'm already condemned to matrimony.
Condemned? I like that. Has your victim passed?
No, but all she needs is a little coaxing.
Don't be too sure. Seriously, Don, you're in no position to get engaged to any girl right now.
Who said anything about getting engaged? I'm talking about getting married. Fast worker.
Golly, little boy. When you get your job with the Navy, then you can begin to think about going down. Sally, you sound just like Mr. Bates. He said almost the same thing.
Say, wait a minute. How do you know what my father said to me?
Well, I don't. I'm merely repeating what he said to me.
Well, I don't get it, confiding in you.
You know how in-laws talk things over.
Well, I had an idea my marriage was something...
Don?
I know it.
If I was in your place, you know what I'd do?
Yes, nothing.
Absolutely. No. No, I wouldn't let anyone or anything stand in my way.
So I've noticed. Don, if I were in your place, I know what I'd do. And I know what I'd do if I were Sally.
You're reading my mind, and it's already made up. Come on, Sally, let's go.
Where are you going?
To Yuma, Arizona, with the future Mrs. Don Bates.
Good.
Well, wait a minute. I don't mind being rushed off my feet, but give me a chance to catch my breath. Haven't I anything to say about this?
Not a word. You're only the bride. What do you say, honey? Yes or yes?
You win. I'm coaxed.
That's wonderful.
This is great. I certainly envy you.
Well, you don't have to. Why don't you and Emily come along? We'll make it a double wedding.
Oh, not Hubert. He has to be at work in the morning.
Yeah, that's it.
Some other time, maybe.
Well, you know best. It would have been fun, though.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
Say, we could make the 9 o'clock plane if we hurry. Come on, honey.
Lots of happiness.
Goodbye. Bye. Good luck.
Kind of sudden, the way they made up their minds, wasn't it?
Well, I don't think so.
You don't feel badly about it, do you?
About them? I should say not. I'm thrilled to death.
That's good.
Oh, here I am neglecting you. I almost forgot tonight was your welcome home celebration. Some music?
Uh-huh.
Aren't you going to ask me to dance?
Oh, surely. If you want to.
You're awfully quiet. Anything wrong?
I was thinking of those two kids eloping. Happy as a couple of larks. Everything ahead of them.
I know.
And here am I, just a sort of a nobody with nothing. I hate to feel this way, but, well, I'm kind of jealous.
Who's to blame except yourself?
What?
You could have everything they have, but you're too blind to see it. Why, you're so cautious you go backward instead of forward. Always hesitating, always in doubt.
Please don't talk that way, Emily.
It's about time I told you the truth instead of humoring you and sympathizing with you. Well, you talk about envying the happiness of others. No wonder it's passed you by. You're afraid to take a chance on happiness.
Why, Emily, you're crying.
Not for myself, for you.
I'm sorry I made you cry.
You didn't.
But you're crying.
Oh, Hubert, will you please go home?
I wish you didn't feel that way.
Stop being a turtle all your life.
A turtle?
Yes, only slower. Give me that apron. You'd look fine going out in the street like that.
Good night, Emily.
Good night, Hubert. And remember, this is no world for timid men.
Hubert, old pal, how are you?
Oh, Fuller.
You going in or coming out?
Oh, neither.
Oh, just tinfoiling, huh?
Uh-huh. When did you fool the Army?
Oh, I'm practically a veteran. Been there almost a week now. Oh. Let you and I have a drink. Oh. On you.
No, I'm the stuff.
Oh, come on, a little drink won't hurt you. Make you feel good. Pep you up.
Well, all right.
Atta boy! Gents. Hubert?
I don't know.
You want to purr or roar?
In between.
Stingerees will do it.
What's that?
Feather with a sharp point.
Sounds interesting. Make his all feather.
Well, Hubert, how are things down at the office?
Not so good. To tell the truth, I could use that money you owe me. Bates cut my salary.
Oh, that's tough luck.
Here you are, boys. Here's how.
Luck.
Peppermint.
I'll have another. Make it two. Hubert, about that dough.
Yes?
Tell you what I'll do. You're holding the bees to my lots of security. Now, I know I'm a sap for doing this, but for another $200, you can keep them.
$200? That would just about wreck my bank account.
Glad you like them.
You're not going to let a mere $200 stand in the way of a steal like this. Well, you're getting high-powered investment, believe you me.
Maybe, and maybe not.
I'll bet you could sell those lots for double, triple what you put in them. This is the chance of a lifetime. Now, don't pass it up.
I guess there's nothing else I can do.
Hubert, I'm doing this because you did me a favor. You'll probably spend the rest of your life just following me around thanking me for it.
Mm-hmm. I will, huh? There you are.
The only reason you're getting these A1 lots is because I'm 1A.
Have a drink.
Oh, thanks, mister. Don't mind if I do.
Huh?
You care if my buddy joins us?
Well, not at all. What'll you have?
Boilermaker's cocktail.
Same here.
What's that? Why, it's whiskey with a beer chaser.
I'll go for that.
You think you're better?
What's good enough for them is good enough for me. Give me 4 mechanical highballs.
My body lies over the ocean. My body lies over the sea. My body lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my body.
Break up that glee club.
Yeah. Say, what'd you serve that guy, the one that goes to the noise?
Him?
Yeah.
His pal gave me the wink. All he's had is fizz water and a dash of bitters. It shows what an imagination can do.
You asked me to sing a solo.
We'll all sing solos together.
I can't do that.
That's enough, boys. That's enough. I'm sorry to break up.
Oh, you stick around. We're just getting warmed up.
But it's 2:00 and we're closing.
Oh, all right, Hubert. Come on, let's go home. Oh, no, you don't. I'm going to make a night of this. I'm having a good time. How much do you owe me?
You owe me $19.95. That includes the 2 rounds of drinks you bought for the house.
2 rounds of drinks for the house? That makes me a great guy.
I wish there were more like you.
$20. Keep the change.
Thanks.
You know, I wish this was Halloween. You know why?
All right, I'll bite.
I feel full of the dickens. I feel like ringing doorbells.
Well, let's do it.
Ah, that's kid stuff. Well, kids have fun, don't they?
Well, settle. Come on, let's ring the only good ones.
Well, there's Myrtle. Oh, no, she's in Panama.
Hey, you know her, too?
Sure.
I know he has. He keeps him in the closet ball with everything else.
Think time. Halloween will soon be over. Come on, fellas.
Come on.
Hey,
you sure this is all right? It's kind of late.
Sure, I'm sure. Mr. Bates is my boss, isn't he? Worked for him 15 years. Let's give him a present, huh? Good evening, Crane. Mr. Crane is the butler. He butlers.
It's so late, Mr. Wilkins. I don't understand.
That's all right. Just tell Mr. Bates I want to see him. Brought some friends.
I'm sorry, sir. He's asleep.
Wake him up and bring some refreshments.
Mr. Bates will be furious, sir.
Oh, we'll sing for him. That'll make him happy. It cheered me up.
But, Mr. Wilkins...
But me no buts, Mr. Crane. Step on it. All right, fellas.
In the evening by the moonlight, you can hear those darkies singing. In the evening by the moonlight, you can hear those banjos ringing. How the old folks would enjoy it. They would sit all night and listen.
Yes.
As they sang in the evening, by the
the meaning of this.
Batesy, old boy, this is a social call. Happy Halloween.
Have you been drinking?
Only feathers and... What was that other stuff?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, rivets.
Feathers and rivets. You want to try them sometime. Sure cure for the blues.
I'm surprised.
It's a surprise party.
Wilkins, I'll give you just 1 minute to explain yourself.
Now, what's the rush? We're in no hurry.
I thank you to keep out of this, sir.
Batesy, you can't speak like that to Mr. Fuller. He's my pal and in the army.
Oh, where's the child?
Hey, there it is. Come get it.
Huh?
Who ordered that?
Mr. Wilkins, sir.
Yeah, I did.
Now, look here, Wilkins. This nonsense has gone far enough. You get out of here and take your friends with you.
Just a minute, Batesy. You're the man who said there's nothing too good for men in the service.
That's perfectly true, but there's a time and place for everything.
All right, then this is the time and place for me to tell you what I think of you.
Will you please get out of my house?
Not until I've finished. When you thought I was drafted, nothing was too good for me. When I came back, you chopped my wages.
That's telling them.
I refuse to discuss that.
All right, then here is my ultimatum. I want my old salary back and a $10 raise on top of it.
Wilkins, I can't understand you. Your conduct is disgraceful.
Well, what of your treatment of me? What's your answer?
Just this. You're fired.
Fuller, did you hear that?
I did.
Fired, huh? Fired by an ungrateful, selfish old cabbage puss.
If you don't get out of my house, I'll call the police.
Give them my regards, and as for you...
It works. Well, what do you know?
Come on, boys.
Bring the sandwich. Yeah. Come on.
Hello, Jimmy.
Hi, Toots.
Where's Mr. Wilkins?
And that's what I've been wondering. If that guy's late, something awful must have happened.
Oh, you mustn't say such things, Jimmy. I wonder if he's ill or if he had an accident.
You mustn't say such things.
Oh, hush.
I hear they're still using telephones.
Bates and Company. Hello. Oh, hello, Emily. I was asleep.
I was worried about you, especially after the way I acted last night. You don't sound very good. Are you sure you're all right?
Yes. Only I'm afraid if I look in the mirror, there won't be anybody there. What do I mean? Oh, Emily, don't be angry, but... I got kind of lit last night and didn't get home till after 3 o'clock.
Oh, God.
Good. What's good about it?
I barged in on Mr. Bates, and after I got through telling him off, he fired me.
Oh, that's the best news I've heard in a long time. Now, look, you go back to bed and don't worry about anything. Oh, I have to go now. I'll come up and see you after work. Goodbye.
Bye.
Took you long enough to get here? You won't need your notebook. I want to read this telegram to you. Dear Dad, Sally and I got married in Yuma, Arizona. Very happy. Hope we have your blessing. Don. Did you know about this? Did you know this was going to happen?
Yes. They planned it at my apartment last night.
So, this is the way you use your influence after the talk we had.
I believe in encouraging romance, not in destroying it.
You admit, then, that you helped persuade them to get married against my wishes.
They didn't need any persuasion, but I did help rush matters a little.
You know what this means, of course.
You won't require my services any longer. I hope.
You hope? You're discharged, and without notice.
I expected as much. But don't think you're discharging me, Mr. Bates. You'll find my resignation in this envelope. I just wrote it.
That will be all, Miss Conway. Except you needn't ask me for a recommendation when you apply for a new position.
I won't. And don't you ask me for one when you hire a new secretary. And another thing. Perhaps now you'll learn that it doesn't peddle in the lives and happiness of others. Or is that something you're too selfish to understand?
I said that would be all.
I haven't finished yet. First, I want to know I'm glad I helped Don and Sally elope before you had a chance to spoil their lives.
Will you please get out of my office?
Any minute now. Second, I'm glad I no longer work for a penny-pinching slave driver.
Will you?
And last, I pity you for being stupid enough to fire the most honest, efficient, and hard-working man in your employ. Mr. Wilkins told me all about it. And now, goodbye, Mr. Bates, and the best of luck. You'll need it.
Bates speaking. Hello, Perry. What's on your mind?
You passed the deadline on that note again. When I gave you an extension, you said you'd take care of it.
How about it?
I'm afraid I'm going to need another 30 days.
Sorry, Mr. Bates. That's out of the question.
You've got to help me. See what you can do. Put it up to the loan committee.
I'm the loan committee. We've had a meeting of your creditors. Now, just a minute. You're out of step with the times. We're in an emergency. And yet you haven't done a thing to meet the situation. You can't sit and wait for the government to help you. You've got to find new markets, new products. Give your organization a hypo. And what's more important, Bates, your firm needs fresh blood. Initiative. New leadership.
You can't take the management of this company out of my hands.
No. I'll expect a list of your assets and a complete inventory of your stock on hand for the creditors' committee in a couple of days. Sorry, Bates, but that's the way it is.
Hey, Clark.
Yes, sir.
Make a complete physical checkup of every item in our warehouse by tomorrow evening.
It's quite a job, Mr.
It has to be done. Get Stokes to help you.
Yes, sir.
And I want a separate inventory on raw silks and any other commodities that come under the government freezing order. Now, check the stock against our books and have the report on my desk day after tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Feeling any better?
Yeah. I think I'm going to live. Never again, Emily.
Shall we drink to that?
Oh, no fair. I mean it. From now on, I'm a sober, conservative landowner. Do you hear that? Landowner.
I'll wait until I see the lot before I say anything.
Well, we'll take a look. Uh-oh. Sycamore Estates. Here we are. Say, this is nice.
Oh, it's beautiful, Hubert, just like a park.
Uh-huh. Oh, look, this is my place. Lot 3, 2, 4, and 5. Make yourself at home, Emily.
Do you mean to say Fuller let all this go for only $600?
Uh-huh. He took a beating, didn't he?
Oh, I can't believe it. Are you sure he owned these lots?
Well, I got the deed right in my pocket. You know what I'm going to do?
Sell?
No, no. When I get a steady job again, I'm going to build a house.
When the war's over.
Oh, of course. Say, now look, right along here, I'm going to have a nice long porch. I like porches.
And the front door here, opening into the living room.
Front door, huh? Nobody answers.
Well, try again. Won't you come in?
Thank you. Would you care for any brushes today?
Oh.
Oh, say, what a nice big living room.
I furnished it all myself.
You did, huh? Then that's taken care of. Where's the dining room?
Oh, the dining room's over here.
Oh, say.
Oh, Hubert, watch out. You'll burn yourself.
What?
That's the fireplace. You almost backed into it.
Say, I gotta be more careful, haven't I?
And now the kitchen. Oh.
Good afternoon. I hope I'm not intruding.
No, not at all, neighbor.
I'm Henry Mason, real estate business.
My name's Wilkins, Hubert T. Wilkins. This is...
It's nice to know you, Mrs. Wilkins.
Oh, no.
Are you the owner of this property?
Yes, sir. I've got lots 2, 3, 4, and 5. All clear.
You've got a good investment here.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if you'd be interested in selling.
Well, that depends. I might consider the right kind of an offer.
I think we can get down to brass tacks without wasting words. This particular piece of real estate looks to me like a good buy. That is, if the price is right.
This is the best of the whole subdivision. I paid 6.
I'll give you 7. There's a quick turnover and a nice profit.
Oh, I'm not so sure that I would want to...
Very well, then, Mr. Wilkins. I'll boost it to $8,000, and that's my limit.
Uh-huh. You said $8,000?
Yes, and not another red cent.
Hmm.
Oh, Hubert.
Huh?
Before you make up your mind, hadn't we better think it over?
Well, I was just about to call it a deal, but you're probably right, Emily.
I don't mean to interfere, Mr. Mason, but we have a business representative, and I feel we should talk it over with him.
What?
Perry.
Oh, Perry, yeah. Perry, he's got a very good business head. I'm afraid that this deal will have to be handled by my financial representative. Could I have your phone number?
Well, here's my card. The terms are $2,000 for each lot. Naturally, I'd like to have all 4 of them, of course. Think it over. I'm making you an excellent offer.
Yes, sir. Kiss me, Emily.
Why, Hubert, what's the matter with you?
I want to see if I'm dreaming.
No, I'm not dreaming.
That was an $8,000 kiss. Come on, Emily.
Well, where are we going?
To the nearest telephone. I'm going to get Perry out here. He'll know what to do.
Come on, get in.
Three cases of jade ornaments. Well, that takes care of the jade, ivory, teakwood, spices, and perfumes. Everything checks.
No reason why it shouldn't.
Textiles are next. We'll start with the silk.
We'll have that go till tomorrow. How about cotton goods first?
Oh, better not. The boss wants a separate inventory on silk.
It's stacked behind a lot of crates. It means moving everything out of the way, and that'll take several hours.
Folks, you're going to get me in bed with the old man.
Not a bit. I'll have everything ready for you the first thing in the morning.
Well, all right.
I'll get the men started on it right away.
What's up?
We're in a mean spot, Jordan.
How come?
This inventory will show us up.
You mean Clark's wise?
Not yet, but he will be when there's a shortage. Have them in here as soon as it's dark. We'll clean up and cash in.
Now you're talking sense.
Right.
Hello, Hubert.
Hello, Perry.
Emily?
Hello, Perry.
Well, here I am with expert advice. These the lots?
Yes, sir. I did pretty well, don't you think so?
As good as money in the bank.
Uh-huh.
Sir, we'll hold out for at least $10,000.
$10,000?
Oh, I'm certainly glad I listened to you, Emily.
You won't like
yes,
that local.
Sir. Now, on the other hand, here's an unusual buy. Four of our best lots. And I can make you a price that you can't refuse.
I beg your pardon, but I haven't decided whether I'm going to sell my lots or not.
Your lots?
Yes, mine. Here's the deed.
Well, there must be some mistake. I'm one of the salesmen for this tract.
Oh, no, I...
Of course, just as I thought. This is section 2. Your lots are in section 9.
No.
Here's the location. Over that way.
Let me see that.
Keep it.
Oh. I knew it was too good to be true.
Section 9, Sycamore Estates. I wonder if it's possible.
You know the property?
I'm afraid to say. I'll let you know when we get there. Come on.
Nine. Yeah.
Yes, this is it, all right. Boy, are you lucky.
Huh?
Or is it worth anything?
Is it worth anything? Hubert, you're standing on a fortune. There's at least $100,000 right under your feet.
Have you gone cuckoo?
I say I have. Listen, Hubert, for 2 weeks, our bank's been trying to find the owner of this property for a customer. The last we heard of him, he was in the Army. The fellow's name is Fuller.
Fuller, that's the guy I got this land from.
Sure.
What's so valuable about it?
It's a hush deal. Our client has quietly been trying to buy up this whole subdivision before the news leaks out.
News? What news?
About bauxite. The ore they get aluminum from.
Oh.
You know, the stuff they need for planes. Well, secret test to prove him that this ground is loaded with it. You're a rich man, Hubert.
I can't get my breath.
Rich? $100,000? What am I going to do with all that money?
I know just the thing.
Huh?
Leave it to me, my aluminum-plated pal.
Oh, no, I'll keep it. That's 2, 3, 4, 5. Four.
Hello? Yes, this is Mr. Wilkins. Chief Air Raid Warden? Blue alert? Oh, yes, right away, sir. Prospect 27711. Hello, Emily? Look, dear, I'm afraid we'll have to call off our date for tonight.
Oh, that's too bad. What will you do for dinner? Well, maybe it won't last long. Do you think there'll be a blackout?
Not unless there's a red alert. I'll call you when I'm through. This'll hold you until then. Goodbye, sweet. Timid man.
Hello, Clark. Don't you ever go...
Glad you showed up.
What's wrong?
Something funny going on. Take a look. Careful.
Do you know any of those fellas?
I can see one of them in the dark to recognize them.
Doesn't look so good. What do you make of it?
I don't know.
Hmm? What are you doing here?
When I was taking inventory this afternoon, Stokes wanted to postpone checking the silk until tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Well, knowing the boss was anxious about it, I...
You came back to finish the job.
Yes, I found these fellows stealing silk.
What are you going to do?
You keep out of sight. I'll go in and see what's going on and meet you on the dock side.
Watch your step.
Noise.
You're hearing things.
Yeah, well, just the same.
Forget it. Remember, you guys, be careful.
Look, you can trust them. They've worked for us before.
Just the same, that stuff means cash. Snooping around here.
Just checking up on a bunch of thieves.
Why, you... Let me handle this. What are you going to do?
Put you in jail where you belong.
A lot of good that'll do you. Look, Wilkins, you got a pretty raw deal from Bates.
Maybe I had it coming.
Not after the years of hard work you put in. I suppose we make it worth something to you to forget what you know.
I don't take crooked money.
Maybe you'll like this better.
That won't stop me.
Maybe this will.
You're a brave bunch of guys.
You know what happens to squealers, don't you?
It's no use, Stokes. You can't bluff me.
You'll change your mind before we get through with you. That's only a sample. How about it? Think you can keep your mouth shut?
No, I don't. You know the government needs all the silk it can get for parachutes. The lives of a lot of our flyers depend on it. And get this. Any man who will steal stuff that's needed for national defense is a low-down traitor.
Let's get this over with.
We gotta get rid of him.
A little lead through his dome will do the trick.
No. No, I get a better idea. Pick him up, boys. All right, follow me.
What are you gonna do?
You find out.
Oh, the hoppers.
Sure,
I get it.
Sure. If they find them, it'll look like an accident.
Yeah, well, let's get at it.
All right, boys. That's that. All right, let's get busy. Come on, rustle it up, rustle it up.
Help! 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 Hold on, Wilkins. What happened? Stokes and George. Haven't time to tell you now. We've got to work fast.
FBI office, John Wayne speaking.
This is Hubert Wilkins. I'm an air raid warden. Listen, the Bates and Company warehouse is being robbed by silk thieves.
Well, keep your eye on them if you can.
I think I know how I can stop them until you get here.
Good, we'll be right over.
Something hot, Chief?
I'll say so. If this tip is on the level, we've got the inside track on that silk racket we've been after.
It's about time.
Get ready. Get me police headquarters.
How you coming?
Almost flat.
I feel terrible doing this with this rubber shortage.
Yeah? Somebody gotta stop him.
Come on, boys.
Jordan, how are we doing?
Just about finished.
Well, hurry it up.
You.
Get these boys going. Pull out of here as fast as you can.
Come on, boys. We gotta make a break for it.
Pull up.
This flat, too?
Yeah, how do you like that? What? Come on, let's get out of here.
No, you don't. Stop. Wait a minute.
I'm looking for Mr. Wilkins. He's air raid warden in this district.
Oh, yes. He telephoned in the tip on this robbery, but I haven't seen him around.
I saw him going after Stokes.
A clerk, what?
He's a shipping manager.
Well, come along with me. I need Wilkins as a witness.
Say not.
Well, I came to bring you coffee and sandwiches, and this gentleman...
I'm Wayne of the FBI. Good work, Wilkins.
I'm glad to know you. You're just in time to pick up what's left of Mr. Stokes, the main guy you're looking for.
We've got something that'll just fit him. And that's a nasty bump you got there. What'd you hit him with?
Tin foil for national defense. What I need is a drink. Where's that coffee, Emily?
Good morning, Mr. Bates.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Bates.
Good morning.
And I wish to assure you that my new duties will in no way conflict with my services as an air raid warden. Address that to the chief air raid warden.
Now look here, Wilkins.
Hello? How are you, Perry? Just a moment. It's for you, Perry Randall at the bank.
Now, look here, Wilkins. I appreciate what you did last night, but you're carrying things too far.
Telephone.
Hello, Perry.
Here's some news for you, Mr. Bates. All outstanding notes and creditors' claims against you have been taken over from the bank. Starting today, there'll be a new man in charge.
New man in charge beginning today? Who? Hubert T. Wilkins. So you're in a position to take over controlling interest.
I can do anything I please with this company. And it would please me most for you to get out. Just a second, Mr. Bates. There's no use. I can't go through with it. I stayed up all night planning how I was going to get even with you. How I was going to throw the hooks into you. But it's no go. There's no satisfaction in it. This is your office, and you belong here. Will you stay?
You really mean that, Wilkins?
Every word of it. You built this company up. I know it kind of hit the rocks for a while, but I've had some luck, and I can tide you over until you get in the clear. I could never handle the job of running this firm.
Wilkins, you're a fool. A wonderful fool.
Then you'll stay?
You couldn't tear me away with a team of horses.
That's good. Well, that settles that. Come along, Emily. Now we've got nothing to do except get married.
Good luck to both of you.
Thank you, sir.
Hadn't we better wait until you...
Hmm? Oh, Mr. Bates. This man Wilkins, what do you think of him? Pretty good worker, isn't he?
Best I ever had.
Then see that he gets a $10 raise.